Next up at the boxing here at Tokyo 2020 is the gold medal bout in the women's welterweight category. A weight division that was introduced for Tokyo 2020. Coming up, the women's so we're about to find out our first gold medalist. Will it be Turkey? Will it be the People's Republic of China? The number one seed against the number two seed. It's Busenaz Sürmeneli, who was just blasted all before her on her route to this gold medal match against the very slick, very sound defensive Chinese veteran Gu Hong. Cuba, the Republic of Korea, Ireland, and Australia, along with Uganda, will be our scoring judges for this women's welterweight gold medal match.
In red, from Turkey, Busenaz Sürmeneli.
Proudly representing her country and her hometown of Trabzon, Busenaz Sürmeneli, the world champion back in 2019. She beat a Chinese opponent in that final. Is that an omen for this Olympic final? There's a bit of a bully about her, and that is no bad thing to be in a boxing ring. Once she gets an opponent where she wants them, they're in trouble. Gu Hong, the number two seed from the People's Republic of China, a very different character. It's all business. Very, very back foot. Very capable. A two-time world silver medalist and has dominated the Asian scene for years and years and years. There's an air of calm and quiet confidence about her. Olympic history being made here then with the first ever women's welterweight Olympic gold medal match. And it'll be a real contrast in styles between the woman in red, Busenaz Sürmeneli of Turkey, and Gu Hong of China. One a come forward pressure fighter and a heavy puncher. The other a very slick, capable back foot boxer. Which one of these two can impose their style on their opponent? They've both dominated on their way through to this gold medal match. Sürmeneli has won three unanimous decisions. Gu Hong had a couple, and then in the semi-final, she comfortably handled the American O'Shea Jones 4-1 and came out of that saying, I'm disappointed, I wasn't at my best. Well, if she's got another level to find that's better than that, she needs to find it now, because if Sürmeneli gets on top, there's a bit of a swagger about the Turkish woman, and she will bully you around the ring. Keeping her at bay, not getting caught by these big, powerful punches, and boy, does she load up. That's got to be the key for Gu Hong. Make a miss, clip her with the counters. And Sürmeneli is certainly thinking her way into this gold medal match. think it's been a bit too easy for her up until now, but now the 2019 world champion is thinking her way into this fight. A real measure of the respect she has for her opponent, and believe me, that is mutual. You can see exactly what Gu is trying to do there. Establish the jab, keep it at distance. Pepper Sürmeneli with that jab. And if she can control this contest behind that jab, maybe it's that left hand that will get her to gold. But once Sürmeneli steps inside that jab, takes it away, then all bets are off. Gu doing the right thing there, not allowing Sürmeneli to build up a head of steam on the inside, which is where she can really break opponents down. A steady start this. No surprise to see Gu backing up and Sürmeneli trying to close her down. But in her previous contests, all of them right up to the semi-final against Lovlina Gugahane of India. She'd worked out an opponent already by this stage and was just full on. Nice body shot there. But look at Gu, clever, just trying to tie her opponent up, neutralize that engine a little bit, take away that work rate. Very good job of spoiling, but she's on the referee's radar here and needs to be careful not to lose a point. Lovely, sharp left hand from Sürmeneli catches the eye. Important this, how you finish the round in a close round, and she's landed again there. And Sürmeneli, as we approach the bell, starting to get a little bit of confidence. These last 20 or 30 seconds might just be the difference maker in this round. Sürmeneli started to get her range, having spent the first couple of minutes trying to track down a very, very elusive opponent who was boxing very well on the back foot. Well, it was clever from Gu. Really intelligent. It's the key to beating Sürmeneli. Make a miss. But even when she does connect, come back with something yourself. But Gu will know. And Zhang Chuangliang, her coach, will be aware. That was a strong finish from Sürmeneli. Who won that first round, though? Gu was certainly effective through the first couple of minutes. And that is reflected in the scorecards with the number two seed from China, 4-1 up. So Sürmeneli knows whatever was working for her at the end of that first round had better work right from the start of this second round. She now needs to try and win this round and turn it into a one-round shootout for Olympic gold. Gu is going to be in the eye of the storm here. And what time remains in this contest? How will she cope with that pressure? Can she keep it at distance? Again, she's just lunging in. But she, yeah. Well, that's been coming. It's been coming. Point off early in this second round as well. Well, she can't have any complaints. She knows exactly what she's doing in there, and the referee knows exactly what she's doing, and he's not having it. So now Sürmeneli can go to work. This is what we've seen her doing. Just walks down opponents, doesn't she? But couldn't pull the trigger there. Interesting that she just didn't let the punches go. Gu is watching her very, very carefully and still peppering those jabs out. Sürmeneli's just got to be smart here. You've got to land. You've got to score. And at the moment, Sürmeneli is letting Gu just pinch it as she did there. Nothing behind these punches, but she dropped in a body shot. Right hand sneaked in upstairs. Gu is being really cleverly effective. Even though all the offensive threat is coming from Sürmeneli, Gu's doing a nice job of messing her up. We're halfway through this second round. And it's another round that really hasn't got going yet. Not the way Sürmeneli would want it to get going. Missing badly with the uppercut there. And as long as Gu's got a bit of distance, she'll feel comfortable. It's either up really close or at range. That's where you want to be with Sürmeneli. Don't be in the pocket. Should break you up if you stand in the pocket. Yeah, nice backhand lead there from Sürmeneli. Well, we're inside the final minute of this one, and Gu's doing enough here. Yeah, just like that, little flurry just to stay busy. Did lose a point, remember.
Stop calling Lu.
Let's see what that does to the tallies Certainly if Sürmeneli is awarded this second round, that point off could be very significant indeed. Time has been called because we need a little bit of a bootlace repair here for Busenaz Sürmeneli. Now, Sürmeneli came on strong at the end of the first round. Does she do the same here? Well, once again, it's Gu that's just out-hustling her. Absolutely nothing behind these punches, but they're scoring. Granted, the big power punch is great, but it doesn't win you very much unless you can knock your opponent on the floor. Another standing out, eight count this time. Another intervention from the referee. A point off and a standing eight count. Oh, that's nice. She got the left hand in there as well, Sürmeneli. Well, now that is certainly going to change the picture. Yeah, Sürmeneli letting Gu Hong know all about it. She just let it slip there. The point off didn't help. And then taking the standing eight count. That's what the heavier punching can do. Probably up until that point, she was pinching the round here. Then suddenly, Sürmeneli made the breakthrough. The referee said, I'm administering a count there. But Gu had frustrated and spoiled and held and was punished for it with the point off. Well, look at the cards there. And look at the overall scores. Busenaz is ahead on all five cards as a result of that, but only by 1 point on four of them. It means Gu Hong has got to make sure that she dominates this fifth round. I think one of the judges has Sürmeneli up 20-17, so that judge has gone. Gu can't win that judge over, but she needs to persuade three of the other judges that she can win this round and make them decide on an overall winner on a tiebreak. It's not impossible, but she's going to have to really work out her strategy here, Gu Hong. She's got to win this round convincingly. No more holding and spoiling now. She's got to go to work, and that's exactly what she's doing here. Having pinched the first round, she let the second round slip away from her. The point off and then the standing eight count. And she'll regret that. She'll also regret another telling off from the referee for hitting around the back of the head. And that was crude. I don't get the sense she's naturally a lead-off boxer. She wants to be a counterpuncher, doesn't she? And she doesn't want to get dragged into any of that because her defenses just vanish when she starts swinging. She just throws from so wide. When you're leaving yourself wide open against Sürmeneli, who's a nasty puncher, you do run the risk of walking onto something big. 2 minutes to go. Sürmeneli just trying to protect what she's got here. But it's a tricky one, because if she does let the round go, well, four judges will have to make a decision. Both of them know they need this last round to be absolutely certain in Sürmeneli's case and to give herself a chance in Gu Hong's case. And this third round is just not developing any kind of rhythm at all. These two and their clash of styles hasn't helped. The headgear hasn't helped Sürmeneli either. And she's very much a rhythm boxer. Doesn't need these stoppages. They don't help. Not at all. Chaitsume, her trainer, won't be very happy with the problems they've had there in this third round. It's given us something else to think about. You don't want to be thinking about anything else other than the opponent in front of you and what you need to do. Well, let's hope in the minute and a half that remain in this one, we can get a bit of a quality showing from both of them. Who is going to be the very first Olympic women's welterweight champion?
Stop wrestling. Oh, you too.
Down to the final minute. The top two seeds Gu will still feel, if I can win this round, I've got a chance. Sürmeneli wants to take that chance away from her. And neither has looked particularly good in this third session. It's been very scrappy, bitty, stop, start. You get the feeling the round is still to be won here. And Gu, I think, senses that. Neither of them has been as effective as we've seen throughout the competition. Gu has done absolutely everything she can just to make this messy. And Sürmeneli hasn't handled it very well. Last few seconds then. Oh, nice, landed a nice right hand on the bell there, and Sürmeneli wanted to touch gloves. Gu just wanted to get back to her corner. That rather summed up the fight. They just didn't seem to get along in any way, did they? They certainly didn't gel. It certainly wasn't high-class quality entertainment, this, the sort of thing that's worthy of an Olympic gold medal. No, they can't always just be barn burners. This one never really took off, but all that matters if you're one of the two boxers, you just want to hear the decision go your way. Sürmeneli had one judge absolutely nailed down, so if you hear a unanimous decision, it's definitely going to be her. But how are those other four judges that had Sürmeneli up by a point going to view that final round? Will they sway it towards Gu Hong? Sürmeneli's got it. It's the kind of fight you'll never look back and watch it and say, wasn't that a brilliant fight? And Busenaz Sürmeneli, though, that won't mean a thing. She's just won gold for Turkey in the women's welterweight division. A history maker. Well, Gu managed to win on three of the cards. She needed a lot more than that. Two of them were level. The other three all went in favour of Sürmeneli. She takes it. She puts Turkey on the women's boxing map. The world champion of 2019 is now Olympic champion. She beat Chinese opposition in the world title fight. She's beaten Chinese opposition in the Olympic gold medal match as well. And that will be sparking some scenes in Turkey and Trabzon in particular. An extraordinary achievement, not a classic, but she deserved it. And she's given us such entertainment throughout the competition as well. Those overwhelming performances against Karolina Koshevska and Anna Lysenko in the round of 16 and the quarterfinals, the clinical efficiency with which she broke up Lovlina Bugahain of India in the semi. And here, she's managed to overcome the riddle of Gu Hong, who wanted to make it a bit messy, and so nearly did it as well. But Busenaz Sürmeneli of Turkey found a way to win, and it's tears of gold for her. Well, Gu Hong knew exactly what she had to do. Take away Busenaz Sürmeneli's strength. That's one of the keys to winning any boxing match. You cannot let Sürmeneli settle, get into a rhythm, and start coming forward and bullying you. Gu took all that away, but in doing so, she took some risks. She had the point off. She got the standing eight count in what proved to be a decisive second round here. That's where she lost it, and she couldn't claw it back in the third round. Sürmeneli takes it, and with that, a historic gold for Turkey. confirmation then of how these scorecards ended up. Two couldn't separate them. But that point off was huge as well. It gave Sürmeneli a bit of a comfort zone. The number one seed takes gold 3-0.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs femmes poids mi-moyen.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the women's welterweight category.
皆様、ただいまより女子ウェルター級の表彰式を行います。
What a proud moment this would be.
Veuillez accueillir les médaillés.
For these four athletes, Sürmeneli, Pong, Jones, and Borgohain. Hours of training in the gym. Loads of sacrifices, I'm sure. And now a dream becomes a reality.
The medals will be presented by
メダルの贈呈は
Monsieur Morinari Watanabe, membre du CIO, Japon.
IOC member, Japan.
IOC, 日本
Accompanied by.
続きまして
Monsieur Willy Kaltschmidt Lujan.Membre du comité de la BTF, Guatemala.
BTF member, Guatemala.
IOC, boxing task force member, Guatemala.
Médaille de bronze, États-Unis d'Amérique et Inde.
Bronze medalist, the United States of America and India.
銅メダリスト、アメリカ合衆国、インド。
オーシェン・ジョーンズ。ラブ・リナ・ボルゴヘイ。
What a proud moment for these two athletes. Both just 23 years young. And now both bronze medalists at the Tokyo 2020 Olympics.A moment they will cherish for the rest of their careers.
Médaille d'argent, République populaire de Chine.
Silver medalist, the Republic, the People's Republic of China.
銀メダリスト、中華人民共和国。
Gu Hong.
An incredibly proud moment for this young woman from the People's Republic of China. 32 years young, a solid performance here at the Kokugikan Arena, and now a silver medalist.
金メダリスト、オリンピックチャンピオン、トルコ。
Busenaz Sürmeneli.
I'm sure the words Olympic champion and gold medalist are words that she has dreamed of. Now, for Busenaz Sürmeneli from Turkey, they are a reality. 23 years young, and now an Olympic gold medalist at the Tokyo 2020 Games.
Mesdames et messieurs, l'hymne de la Turquie.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Turkey.
皆様、トルコ国歌の演奏です。
I'm sure this moment is a proud one for those four athletes from Turkey, China, the United States of America, and India. The medalists, gold, silver, and bronze in the women's welterweight category. See the emotion from Team Sürmeneli. It was a tough final between Sürmeneli and Hong. And you can see what it means to our Olympic champion. A powerful, emotional day. Day 15 action here at the Kokugikan Arena for men's and women's boxing. Champions crowned, moments made, and dreams realized. And we hope you enjoyed all of the action from the Kokugikan Arena here at the Tokyo 2020 Olympics.